Well, I've been using my 12-inch jet joiner a lot lately, and over the last couple weeks I had a whole lot of really long pieces that I had to face join, plane, and then edge join. And what I realized was I wanted to start wearing my knives a little more evenly as I was doing all this edge joining. But this design of guard does not really allow for an easy shifting of the fence with it out, without it being in your way. So say you shifted the guard over here to do edge joining more in this intermediate part of the cutting barrel. You know, the more you come out here as you move to wear different parts of your knives, now this becomes a really awkward proposition to try to, especially if you're joining long boards, to join a board and you have to manipulate yourself around this guard. It's just awkward. I mean, overall, I think this guard is really, really fantastic in that, you know, especially for face joining material, you know, you've got this full coverage of the cutting barrel as your face joining material, you know, so you can keep it very snug, and you know, you can reach over it really easy while you're transitioning from in feed to out feed. So overall, it's fantastic. This is the limitation that I found, but the solution to that limitation is really, really simple. You just make yourself a couple little intermediate guards that fit in here. So when you do need to move to this part of the cutting barrel, you just take this out and you pop in. This is quarter inch Baltic with a half inch Baltic glued onto it, no screws or nails in it. And there's no you know, changeover or anything that you have to do. So now you've got a real simple intermediate cutting barrel protector that, you know, didn't cost me anything to make other than a few cents and scraps and a little bit of glue. So now I'm here, I can move around the jointer guard very comfortably and easily. And so it's working very well. And I made a little bit shorter one, so when I do want to be at the full distance that the fence moves to, I can be right in here like this. And you know, really have nothing to hang up on as I'm going around it. Let me bring the camera down and I'll show you how well these work in this situation. And they don't, like I said, it doesn't take any switch over or anything. It just fits in there just perfect. Simple to do. And I want to show you how easy it is to switch between my homemade guards and the factory guard that came with my jet machine. So you just, all it is maybe just a few extra turns on that knob. So just back it off just a little bit more. So there's the factory one installed, ready to go. There's one of my homemade ones. Now I know that this is an issue with this style of guard sticking out way too far. And the reason I know it is an issue that people are dealing with is because the Austrian tool company Felder, they actually have this style of guard where it's actually hinged in several positions. So as you do bring the guard out, you can fold it down so it's not going to be an obstruction as you're trying to pass around it. But you But on a joiner, you have to keep the cutting barrel shrouded and protected. It is just too dangerous a machine. You won't, if your fingers or any body part touch the cutting barrel, you're not going to get anything back to have someone sew on. It's an essential part of a joiner to have the blade covered at all times when you're working. And it's just not an option to have an exposed cutting barrel on a joiner. And this is a real simple solution right here. to make it more convenient to pass around the jointer and just give you more safety options when you're working on it.